Now that the parameters are set for the membership site, the content can be protected. The way you protect content will depend on your site focus. S2Member installs a metabox on each page and post screen. The membership level is selected from this drop-down, and there's also a place for the custom capabilities. This is the place for the MEMB and the ECOMM tags we set up in a previous video. S2Member also has the ability to protect content for each level in various ways. To set content restrictions, navigate to the S2Member Restriction Options page. Content can be protected by post by entering the post ID in a comma-delimited format. The post IDs can be found in the All Posts table under the ID column that the WP Show ID plugin installed. This is the plugin that we installed in a previous video. Also, if you're using custom post types, they can be protected by entering the word all, A-L-L, all lowercase, followed by dash, and then the custom post type. All-movies would protect the all-movies custom post types, for instance. Page restriction is handled in the same way as the post restriction with the page ID. Enter the ID under the level separated with a comma. Tags are different. Tags use the name of the tag. And with the Tag Page Tagger plugin we installed in a previous video, all the pages along with the post can be tagged to use the tag restriction. Category restriction is handled like the post and page restrictions with a category ID listed under the level. Category IDs can be found on the Post Category screen. And URI restriction can be used to protect entire sections of the site by using the URI or Uniform Resource Identifier. This is the part of the URL after the dot extension in the site domain name. This is typically used when there's a plugin like BuddyPress installed. And a specific post or page restriction can be used to sell access to a specific post or a page. This can be sold to anyone, even non-members. This is a file that is not protected by any membership levels. This is a specific page or post, like an ebook, that you want to sell to members and non-members alike. One of the restrictions we'll set in place is the alternative view protection. Alternative view protection filters WordPress database queries. WordPress searches, content excerpts from XML feeds, archive views, and even comment feeds. This is an added layer of protection for the site. You can select what is appropriate for your site. For the course, we'll use the Filter All WordPress Queries so we can have this added protection. Select the box and then click the Save All Changes button. Two other forms of restrictions that you should be aware of are the brute force IPN slash login restriction and the unique IP access restrictions. These are both on by default, but can be adjusted or even turned off. Brute force is when someone tries to guess the username and password by trying different combinations. Brute force restriction limits the number of attempts or failed logins within a set time period. If this number is exceeded, then a ban is placed on that person for 30 minutes. You can adjust this to fit your site by selecting from the drop-down. This feature can be disabled by selecting the Allow Infinite Failed Logins, and it can be reset by clicking the Reset Brute Force Logs. And the Unique IP Access Restrictions works to prevent a member from sharing their username and password with a non-member by monitoring the entry points to the membership site. If a member exceeds the maximum unique IP addresses set, then they will be temporarily banned. Select the number of unique IDs allowed, and then select the banned period. This feature can be disabled by selecting the Allow Infinite IPs, and it can be reset by clicking the Reset IP Restrictions Logs button. Remember to click the Save All Changes button at the bottom of the screen to activate any changes. As your site grows and matures, these restrictions can be revised to make your site flexible and user-friendly.